services were?
At the beginning of the service.
Okay.
Amen. As we light the Advent wreath tonight, I'll be reading from Luke 2, verses 13 through 14. Suddenly, the great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." On this most holy day, we light all four candles in our Advent wreath, and we are reminded of the hope, peace, joy, and love of the good news. Now we light the Christ candle. We rejoice that the promise of God has been fulfilled in the coming of the baby born in the manger. Let us pray. Gracious and mighty King, we celebrate your goodness to us as we join the triumph and joy of Christmas. As your love has been revealed in all of its fullness, we pray that love may abound in our hearts during this special day. May we live in the light of your love and spread the good news every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Now we'll sing together, "It Came Upon the Midnight Clear," number 218.
Thank you. recorded.
Yeah, it is not recorded.
Oh.
Technical difficulty.
Thank you.
That's what my phone does.
It does.
We had technical difficulties with our broadcast, but hopefully we are broadcasting now. From Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. May God have blessed in reading, hearing God's holy word.
Thank you.
We're just not going to worry about it. We've got one that is working. I've been doing a dual broadcast because we've been having trouble with the other one. So I've been broadcasting on my phone. Is it night? Apparently not. So hopefully people are able to find the live broadcast. I always feel bad when we have technical difficulty, but we're not going to worry about it. Luke 2, 8 through 14. And there were shepherds living out of the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. Thank you. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior has been born. He is Christ, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to men on whom his favor rests."
Oh,
receive the offering. I mentioned this morning that if you were here this morning, you're off the hook tonight. So, and offering's not required of anyone. It is an offering. So feel free to participate or not as you are able. Thank you.
Oh, lonely man. What then can I give him? Empty as I am. If I were a shepherd, I would bring a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would know my
And now, the final section of chapter 2, now verses 15 through 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which is the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning him, concerning what they had been told about him. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. May God have a blessing to the reading and hearing of God's holy word. He is here. Not tonight as a babe in Bethlehem, but Christ has come, and we celebrate his birth this night. We celebrate the gift of God and the news of the angels. I would that peace had already come on earth, that we were all living in full relationships with everyone else around us, that we were at peace with our neighbors and in our families, among our friends, among our exes and whatevers. But the reality is that peace has not yet come on earth. And some take that as an opportunity for doubt. They say to themselves, if God is all-powerful, why isn't God doing something about it? My answer is that God has given us the most wonderful and terrible gift ever imagined. God has given us free will. We have the opportunity to be at peace with our neighbors. We have the opportunities to love everyone we know. We're not called to love people on the other side of the world that we will never meet, nor are we called to hate them. Love is a very personal action. It's something that we can do with others. that we meet, or certainly with those we know. But we have all these other things that get in the way. Pride, anger, unforgiveness, and even hate. And because of all of those things, we choose not to act on love. But tonight is an opportunity to remind us all that we are called to love and forgive, to make the reality of the angel's proclamation real in our lives. Many years ago, I was approached by a church member who had become estranged with a sibling. And, you know, they wanted me to fix it. And the one sibling that was in my congregation was before me, and the other one I didn't know. And I didn't know how to help them fix their relationship. And I told her, all you can do is continue to love and pray for your sister. Extend that love in every way that you can. But you've got to be patient, because she has to want to restore that relationship as well. And that's often the case. That's why so many people end up estranged from one another, is because someone in that relationship isn't willing to lay down their hurt, to forgive as we have been forgiven. I wish I could fix all of the hurt just represented among us, let alone in our community and in our world. But all I can do is continue to be faithful and to love those within my reach, to love those in my circle, and to keep on loving and hope that that love spreads, that that love catches in your hearts, so that in your circle it begins to expand in love. Imagine what would happen in Okeechobee if all of us laid down any resentments and hurts that we've experienced and just began to love our neighbors. I believe it would create a transformation in our community that could not stay contained in Okeechobee. As far as we are from so many other places, I believe that love is contagious, and that love, as it takes hold in one heart, can spread to another and another and another. So who knows how far it can go? Can it make it to Fort Drum, Bassinger? Can it make it to Fort Pierce? All of us know people in far-flung places. Might love exemplified in us take up residence in far-off places and spread from that person to another, to another, to another? We are often praying for revival. Pastors do that on a fairly regular basis. But I don't know if we really know what revival would look like if love took hold. If peace on earth became not just something that was declared by angels long, long ago. It became something that took residence in us. I believe that Christ has the power to change our hearts if we desire. Maybe, even if all of us began to do it, maybe no one would ever take notice. But we would know the peace that we experience in our lives as we seek to love as we have been loved. Free will is a wonderful and terrible gift. Because we have the ability to say no. I'm not going to do it. Pastor, you don't know what they've done to me. I'm not going to forgive. I'm not going to let my love be shared with them. I can't undo those hurts. They're real. And even if they're imagined, they're real to us. But I believe, as surely as I believe anything, that we must forgive to experience the fullness of God's forgiveness in our lives. And so, as hard as it is, that is my challenge to all of us tonight. To love as we have been loved. To forgive as we have been forgiven. To share peace on earth. May this Christmas season represent the beginning of a change in us, a change that will spread as far as we have reach and keep spreading until the world knows there is peace on earth. Let us pray. Dear God, it starts with us. Forgive us. Lord, take our hurt and heal it. Not because others deserve it, but because we need to forgive. in order to experience the fullness of your love, Lord. Help us forgive. And may it spread and spread and spread. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
The candles that you have, normally, you know, in years gone by, we would, the pastor would light this candle from the Christ candle and come down, and we would all light our candles from that candle, and it kind of spreads through the room. A few years ago, we went with the electric candle, and all it requires is us to flip on the switch. So, it's on the bottom, and as we sing Silent Night, which is in your bulletin, I would invite you to light your candle and hold it as we sing. We have a problem with our lights. We don't have a lot of control over the dimming and the lighting right now, and so it's liable to get very dark. It's either going to stay like this or it's going to get really dark, and I'm going to try to do it in such a way that we won't be completely in the dark and only lit by our candles. But if we are, there's still a narthex light out there, and they're lighting the hallway over here, so we'll be safe, I think. But let's do Silent Night.
Oh.
Christ, who is the light of the world, light our hearts and illuminate our way. May peace begin with us. May love begin with us. And may it spread and spread and spread. Amen.
Amen. Amen.